kids and jam friends. Let's play a game of would you rather. Would you rather be sick or healthy? Would you rather have friends or not have friends? And would you rather win or lose? What? These questions kind of seem silly because of course you would rather win. But sometimes in our lives, we do lose. We lose games, we lose friends, and even our health. Sometimes we lose when it comes to sin. We choose to say yes to sinning instead of saying yes to God. But Jesus never loses. He has won against sin and won against our enemy Satan. Say it with me. Jesus wins. Do you know what the big story in the Bible is? It is the story of God's plan to save the world from sin. But what if God's plan was stopped by God's enemy, leaving the world trapped in sin and darkness forever? Today we're going to talk about Satan and how Jesus wins against Satan. Remember when I shared that the angels are powerful and amazing beings created by God to serve and worship Him? A very long time ago, one of the angels decided he was not happy with doing what God wanted. He wanted to do whatever he wanted and wanted to be the one in charge. So he turned away from God and was no longer allowed to be in heaven. This angel became known as Satan or the devil. He is God's enemy and wants to ruin God's plans. But it's not possible for Satan to ruin God's plans. God is all powerful, he knows everything, and he is everywhere all at once. Satan can't do any of these things. He has some power, but not all power. Satan knows some things, but not everything. He definitely cannot be everywhere at once. God is strong, wise, and loving. Satan is none of these things. God wins every time. But that doesn't stop Satan from trying to ruin God's plans, though. Satan came to Adam and Eve as a serpent and tempted them to sin. Temptation or being tempted is a strong want to sin. Remember what Adam and Eve did? Satan tempted them into disobeying God and having them eat from the fruit from the tree that God told them not to eat. Adam and Eve both broke God's one rule, bringing sin into the world. Satan thought that he had won a victory against God when he tempted Adam and Eve. But right after Adam and Eve sinned, God made a big promise. God would send a savior who would be powerful enough to defeat sin and Satan because the savior wouldn't have any sin of his own. Who is the savior? It's Jesus. The Bible says that right after Jesus was baptized, remember by John the Baptist, he went into the wilderness for 40 days. Jesus fasted during this time, meaning he did not eat anything. He must have been very hungry since, you know, Jesus may be the Son of God, but he was also fully a man. But during this time in the wilderness, Jesus spent, you know, spending time with God and the Holy Spirit, but Satan came along and started tempting Jesus to sin. If Jesus sinned, then he would be trapped in sin too and wouldn't be able to rescue us from our sin. But it was part of God's plan that Jesus was to be tempted. Now, why would God do that? Well, Jesus needed to be tempted by Satan to prove that he cannot sin and that he is the only one worthy of being our savior. Jesus is stronger than Satan. Now, in part two, I'm going to tell you all about the battle between Jesus and Satan. As Satan tried to be sneaky and cunning to tempt Jesus in the wilderness, we know that Jesus wins. So I may be spoiling the ending here a little bit, but still go to the Hope Church website, click on Kids Service, and watch the rest of the story.